of, you know, Canelo signed that record deal with his own, right? And he has that deal made, and then he loses it through no fault of his own, right? You could see him being bitter, but he's not, right? And I wonder, like, what's in his mind that you know of about, you know, like how he does business deals? Because obviously he's not going to do a deal with Oscar again, but DAZN seemed like it didn't bother him.
Yeah, I think it took a bit of time, you know, to sort of, for everyone to feel comfortable again. I think that one thing I've learned about Canelo is he likes to do good business and honest business. And if a deal is right and if he trusts the people, like, I think that when a relationship breaks down like his did with Golden Boy, there's becomes a trust issue. It's a bit like having a normal relationship with a female or a man where you split up and something might have happened, something went wrong, and your next relationship, you don't trust that person because of what happened in the past. So there's definitely an element of that, and that it's always difficult to start a relationship when that's happened in the past. So it's taken a little bit of time for him to maybe, you know, get comfortable with DAZN again and us. And now I think he trusts us. And that's the nicest feeling in a relationship.
Sure.
With a fighter or with a man or a woman, if you're in a relationship where everybody trusts everyone and you're happy. And that's when you have the best relationship with a fighter, is when the fighter says to you, you're the man, right? So you do, I trust you. I put my career in your hands. That's an incredible responsibility to have in a sport like this. And that's when I get most motivated, because I won't let you down in that situation, because you've entrusted me to handle your career. And in Canelo's case, it's the career of pound for pound number one.
Right.
You spoke about this relationship. Ain't doing much. Take a step back.